Dear viewers, you're watching Serbian television. With us here in the studio is Dalibor Mihajlovic. Welcome.
Thank you.
Dalibor, please tell us a little bit more about your tennis career.
Well, my tennis career started when I was 9 years old. I started by fluke, I would say. I was going in school, and one of the coaches, local coaches, came by and offered some free tennis lessons. And at that time, I was very interested because everyone played soccer, everyone plays basketball, so I wanted to be something different. I wanted to try tennis, and that's how I started. So started when I was 9, practiced in Serbia until I was about 16, and then I came to United States, went to tennis academy in Florida, then I got scholarship to go to Indiana State University, and when I was done with college career in 2003, I started working as a tennis coach.
And you graduate financing, right?
Yep, I graduated with finance, yep, from Indiana State University.
Mm-hmm. And tell us about a little bit more, like you were winning a lot of games, right? Your matches and all the stuff, right?
Yeah, I won a lot of junior matches back home in Serbia. Then also when I came over here in the United States, did pretty good, I would say, in college, and played for the team that was top 20 in the nation at the time. So I would say very successful junior and college career.
Mm-hmm. And what made you stop? When you made you like say, okay, now I'm going to be a trainer?
Prior to going to college, I played a couple of professional tournaments and then decided to get my education at the same time as I was playing tennis. And once I was done with college, which was in 2003, I was 22 years old at the time, and which is considered kind of, I would say, a little too old for a tennis player to start a tennis career at that time. So at that time, it was a decision either we go with a professional tennis or start coaching little kids, I would say juniors, and I decided to go with a different route. I just decided to be a coach.
Mm-hmm. And now you coach in the Hinsdale, right?
Yeah, I coach at Hinsdale Racquet Club.
And how that goes?
I like it. I like it. It's a fun job, and I enjoy working with kids, and I enjoy getting them to the point where they can be the best they can be.
Mm-hmm. And now we can see Novak Djokovic, number one in the world.
Yeah.
So do you feel like, oh my gosh, maybe I should do the same? I had a chance.
Well, yeah, I mean, definitely crosses my mind. How, you know, what would have been if I stayed in and if I practiced harder, if I worked a little harder. But, that's the past and there's nothing I can do. All I can do right now is hope that one of my students will be number one in the world, just like Novak.
Mm-hmm. And tell us a little bit about like number one, number 20, number 100. What's the difference? It's slight difference, little of difference, a lot of technique. So what is the difference the most?
I would say between one and 100 in the world, there's a very small difference when it comes to technique. As far as forehands, backhands, serve, they all know how to do that. They all know how to hit those shots, and they're really good at it by being top 100 in the world. I think the biggest difference between those players would be, I would say, conditioning level, and I also would say mental part. Mm-hmm. How ready are they to handle the tough, situations in the match and to handle the pressure?
The welcome for Novak Djokovic was really spectacular in Belgrade, 100,000 people. And he introduced all family, everybody. He said, this is all my team. He first investors and supporters and trainers and whole family, grandfather, grandma, everybody was there, aunts, uncle, mom, dad, and his brother, of course, right? So teamwork, right?
Tennis it might be looked at as individual sport, but it is a team sport. It takes a lot of dedication. It takes a lot of work. And as you said, it's not just by yourself. I mean, there is a lot of teamwork off the court as well, starting with the coaches, such as tennis coach, conditioning coach, to your family members as well. You know, not just including mom and dad, but your brothers, your grandparents, and everyone is involved, and everyone played some part at one point in his career, definitely.
I heard Novak's mom said that's a 20 years of sacrifice, a lot of devotion. How was in your life? Did you have the support?
Yeah, I had a lot of support from my family, my closest family, and as Novak's mom said, that was a lot of sacrifice. That was a lot of sacrifice of not hanging out with friends and just focusing on tennis, and tennis pretty much being everything in my life. Practice in the morning, practice in the afternoon, you know, going to school in between practices, doing homework after practices, staying up late nights to do homework to make sure that I keep up with school at the same time. So it's a lot of sacrifice. And Novak's mom saying it's been 20 years of hard work, I truly believe that. And it's a hard work, but as we all know, it paid off at the end.
A couple of years ago, I spoke with Viktor Trojicki for the Serbian television, and he also won against Novak Djokovic. He's number 13 right now, right? Tell us about him. What kind of chances he has?
Yeah, Viktor is currently number 13, and he does have a big chance with the talent that he has, and considering his age, he still has, in my mind, plenty to improve. And I do see Victory next year or so to be in top five. He has been constantly in the top, I would say 30, 40, and slowly making his move up. And he's not making such a dramatic move to go up and then dramatic, you know, going down. So it's more like consistent with his play, with his rankings or so. So as I say, at this point, he's number 13, but I do definitely see Victor in top five.
Mm-hmm. How about other guys?
Janko is right now at his currently highest ranking, which is 26. I'm expecting a lot more from Janko in the last couple of years. I would say not as consistent as we've seen maybe from Victor or Novak, but to be honest with you, I mean, being 26 in the world, it's still a big, big success.
Mm-hmm. And how about the girls? What's happening with our girls, Yelena and Hannah? What's happening there?
We don't know yet, and we're still trying to figure out. I think everyone is trying to figure out what's going on with Hannah, what's going on with Yelena. My personal opinion, it's just the girls' tennis, a lot different than men's tennis, or let's just call it women's tennis. There is just a lot of, I would say, switching around as far as the ranking-wise. I mean, from 1 to 20, you just don't know who will end up being number one. We have a player, Wozniacki, who has not won a major ever in her career, being number one, to, you know, having players such as Sharapova, who has been out of tennis for a couple of years, to coming back and playing finals of Wimbledon. So anything's possible. Anything's possible on a given day. And I know we haven't seen much of Anna and Yelena, their success lately, but I do hope to see them back and, you know, being top five, top 10 in the nation. I mean, sorry, in the world.
Mm-hmm. And that sounds really great. Any of your students that you can see maybe in the future prospecting a lot?
Yes, I do have I do have one student, one girl that I've been working with for the last 4 or 5 years. Her name is Angelia Božović. She's currently 12 years old. She is top five in the Chicago area and top 15 in the Midwest region. And even though she's still young, she's still 12, there's still a lot of work ahead of her. And with a good program and hard work in the next 4 or 5 years, we do hope to see her out there as well.
Is her family supporting her?
Absolutely. Her family is very supportive of her.
That's very, very important. Our viewers wondering, maybe I should consider tennis too. What is the most important thing? Any advice?
Well, my advice would be anyone that is considering playing tennis, even if it's just for fun, they should definitely pick up the racket, you know, get a couple lessons, get involved in the game, because to me, the tennis is the game for life. You can play tennis, you know, as a kid, you can play tennis later on as an adult, and I've seen people play tennis even when they're 60, 70, 80 years old. It's so much easier once you get to that age to just find a tennis partner than it is to find a team sport of, you know, 10, 11 guys to enjoy the game and for exercise. If nothing else, then just for exercise. So I would definitely suggest people that are considering or thinking about just to, you know, get a couple lessons and just start playing tennis.
USPTA, what that means?
USPTA stands for United States Professional Teaching Association, and it's the most known in the world and the most recognized teaching association. And I have achieved the highest level of certification at that association about 4 years ago, and it's every year there's certain requirements in order to keep the certification. So I'm proud to say that as of right now, I have achieved the highest certification at the association.
So if someone looking for a trainer, say, okay, Dalibor was there, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's how it works. Usually the students, when they're picking the coaches, so they do go by, you know, the there's a website that you can go on, and then you can search all the coaches in the area. And then usually the way they work out is that they pick the highest certified coach in the area to go with.
Okay, and you're working with beginners too?
I do. I work with, I would say, ages 6 to 66, and beginners, advanced. I work with, as I said, with some top juniors in the area as well. So anyone who is looking for a lesson, I will be more than happy to help them out.
And how you see yourself in next 4 or 5 years?
I do see myself at the club that I'm at right now, which is Hinsdale Racquet Club, working with juniors, working with Angelia, and hopefully in 5 years I could be sitting in VIP seats as her coach while she's winning the Wimbledon.
Oh, that will be really nice. Thank you so much for being guest of Serbian television. I hope we see you in maybe in a couple of months. Maybe, who knows, maybe we ask you to help us out with US Open or something like that. Who knows? You know, maybe if you're there, maybe we can ask for your opinion, your suggestion, comments, or something like that for Serbian television website. By the way, on serbiantelevision.com, you can find really great information about Novak Djokovic, number one in the world, right?
Yep. So anytime, mm-hmm. anytime I can help.
Thank you so much. Again, dear viewers, we almost the end of our program. Stay tuned till end. Enjoy the music.